Hello, folks.
Right. I've decided that the first bike I'm going to fettle is actually the last bike that I showed you, the Raleigh Transit. Now, it's one of those days where it doesn't really get light up north, but the workshop is so full, I thought I'd give us a bit of space out here where we can see things properly. Yeah, so I'm going to go through it, and it shouldn't take long. It's all fairly straightforward, although there is more to it than might first appear. Things like little nuts and bolts and fastenings to be replaced because they're rusty, and that takes extra time. As I've said before, I don't have to repeat it too many times, the front wheel is coming out. I've got a spare wheel already, and the tyres already, or they could do with a scrub. I'll put some pedals on last. We need a new gear cable, and looking at it, I think we might already have a 20 tooth on the back of there. If not, I have one here. That might be an 18 that's on. I'll compare it when I get the wheel off and put the bigger one on. The chain, yeah, the chain's a bit worn, see? Not being a derailleur chain, it shouldn't do that. So that's worn. That's microscopic wear in every one of the pins. I'm gonna fit the kickstand. I'm gonna fit the Plesha carrier, which is down here. Put a reflector on to hold that together. Change the saddle, of course, and the grips. And there we are. So, less waffle, more action. Right, you're in the tripod. Let's get going. That's the Raleigh hub with the stepped washers. It's got a Woods valve in here, which makes this a lot easier. There we are. Tire and tube off, and then I'll salvage what I can out of this wheel. But I think its days as a bicycle wheel are over. Very tight. Well, I've got a couple of, albeit dirty, brake calipers that have got good components on them, so they're going to be salvaged to replace the rusty ones. I won't just swap the whole brake, there's no need. I think that is going to be replaced. That is really stiff on that. This is annoying. These levers, when they're on the bike, they don't come out quite far enough until you twiddle them around for the cable to come out like this, out of the slot on the back of there. Right, that is sort of stuck together, so that's for the rubbish. Could look for a split link in here, but I think it's going to be just as quick and easy to do this. In fact, if I had my bolt croppers handy, it would just be a quick snip with them. putting disc on an angle grinder is pretty instantaneous as well. Now while I'm here, this gear cable is kinked and has little threads sticking out of it right there, so that's toast. Just slacken off the fulcrum clip a little bit. So that can come out. And then we'll have that as well. There we are. Now that it's down as far as it's going down, a pleasant interlude. Going to give the frame a good clean and polish, and then oil the cables, and then we're putting things together. So there we are, a nice little clean, and I decided against clear coating in this instance. It's a metallic, it's dark, you know, a clear coat would maybe add some sparkle to it. It's also very original. There are a couple of tiny little scuffs in the top layer which a clear coat might take out, but I think I'll leave that choice to the next owner. It will need a wipe over with white spirit before clear coating, because it's now got silicone polish on it. But apart from that, it's the next person's choice whether they clear coat. It's looking very nice, even though the camera isn't really picking it up. While the wheels are out, of course I've got to change the sprocket on the rear one, change the tyres on both. But on the bike itself, I need to do something about this. Loose mudguard stay with lack of reflector. You can see there's been a reflector on there, so I can't get away with not putting anything on. And of course, attach the rack. That's best done before I put the wheel back in for access inside. Now, while you have been away, we have had what could best be described as a bit of a reflector situation. Stocks, let's say, have become rather depleted. I'm going to have to go through my mudguard stash and check for stray reflectors. Part of the problem is the Raleigh reflectors that I do have are all this shape, so they're moulded to the old style of domed mudguards with the trouser crease up the middle, and that's what we've got just about everywhere. That is for one of the Speedwell type mudguards, the ones with five different flat planes from 82 onwards, but I had nothing for flat mudguards, so I had to do a little bit of carving to get one on. Just needs a little zhuzh to clean it up, but the important thing is we've got one on. Thought I was going to have to put something modern on there. Yuck. I'd rather spend half an hour of my limited lifespan cleaning an old reflector and carving it to shape and fit a modern one on. Time to fit the carrier. Now we have hit some good luck here because the frame comes with the two holes, as does the rack. And once that brake is central, the rack won't foul the brakes, because it's tried and tested fitting these on here. And oh yes, we are using stainless steel. Putting the screws in from the back. These are actually socket head screws, but they're subtle looking little dome heads, you can't tell from a distance. Put them this way through, it's just easier for when we need to tighten them at any time or change the carrier or remove the brake. I think I had a little rant about this with another bike the other day, about rack mounting screws being put through the wrong way. Look at that original ...44 years old. Everything just comes apart as it should. So these bosses are threaded. Those nuts on the inside are just an extra belt and braces safety measure. I'm hoping this is going to be long enough to go through again. I'm working against a little bit of tension now as the rack is trying to hold itself horizontal at the top. Now this is a rack for a 28 inch wheel. It's just come off my Batavus with 700c wheels. As I'm constantly saying about rallies, you have to get one for a 28 inch wheel, even though it's a 26 inch wheel bike, because the dropout, the lug is down here instead of up here where it would be on any other bike but a rally. They just had to be different, didn't they? There we are. Changed the shifter. Not only was it rusty, but it was the wrong type. It was a 1960s shifter. I also had a 60s bike with a too late shifter on, so that's on here now. There we are. We're getting there. Grips. Before I tackle the wheels, grips. Miraculously, actually coming off. Nice original grip. I shall keep that, knowing it's from this bike. And if anyone buys this bike, they can have those. By which I mean they can have a choice. They can have the new grips on, they can have these in a little bag. I have discovered by comparison that the bike already had a 22 tooth sprocket on there. That's just made life a little bit easier. these shredder valves with the rubber around the outside. I hate those so much. You can't even get the pump fully onto them. Horrible things. Prefer a shredder valve, but I hate these rubber covers. And of course you can't put the retaining collar on as well to hold them nice and upright. Bad, bad, bad. Nice. Check those anti-rotation washers, there we are. Can't go any further with that till I get the chain on, so that's next. Well, that was a rather abrupt stop because my battery was down, and then by the time I could get any charge in, the light was going, so I just cracked on. So I'm sorry that you've missed the edifying spectacle of me fitting some new cables. I put a Brown Brook saddle on and my Tweed Caradice Barley to go with the brown grips. I think it looks rather splendid. One thing left to be done is fish out a couple of clips and just clip that Sturmey Archer cable in place, and then we are finished. One Raleigh Transit. I hope to get a ride in on it in the next few days. That'll be nice. So thanks for watching. It's nice to get the first of the five bikes actually through and on the road. Wayfarer next, I think. But there is a new development. Something else is coming. Something else from Owls, but not from Owls. If that sounds cryptic, it's meant to. You'll see what I mean in a day or two. So stick around, make sure you're subscribed for the renovations of all these other bikes and the introduction of yet another new one. And then this weekend there's quite possibly yet another new one, and that'll have to be it. That'll be seven then. Okay, thanks very much for watching. As I said, see you soon. Stay safe. Bye bye now.